Let's first get you a sense of what's happening in the national capital after the tractor rally violence yesterday. The Delhi police is on high alert this morning. Situation was brought under control last evening. Vehicular movement on most of Delhi's borders is back to normal after it was completely blocked yesterday. So far, a total of 7 FIRs have been registered in connection with violence in several pockets of the national capital. Protesters have been booked under sections of assault on public servants, destruction of public property, vandalism, among others. Over 83 policemen who sustained injuries during yesterday's violence are stated to be critical. A special Home Ministry team has been constituted to monitor the entire situation. Heavy security has also been deployed at the Red Fort area. Protesters have been made to return back to their protest sites, to Delhi's borders. A high alert has also been sounded in neighbouring Punjab as well as Haryana. Internet has been snapped now in at least 3 Haryana districts as a precautionary measure.
इस वक्त मैं लाल किले पर मौजूद हूं और यहां परिस्थिति देख पा रहे हैं। सभी प्रदर्शनकारियों को यहां से निकाला जा चुका है। भारी पुलिस बल की तैनाती फिलहाल लाल किले की एंट्री गेट से अंदर की है और यहां तस्वीर आपको दिखाऊं, ये ट्रैक्टर अंदर से, लाल किले के अंदर से ये ट्रैक्टर अभी अभी निकाला जा रहा है। बहुत मुमकिन है जो प्रदर्शनकारी थे वो इस ट्रैक्टर पर भी अंदर दाखिल हुए हैं। फिलहाल अगर आप देखें, ये एंट्री गेट है लाल किले का। अभी अभी जो जानकारी मिली है उसके मुताबिक सभी प्रदर्शनकारियों को निकाल दिया गया है लाल किले के अंदर से, और लेकिन लाल किले के अंदर तमाम जो दिल्ली पुलिस के सीनियर ऑफिशियल हैं वो अंदर बैठे हुए। सर, लाल किले से सबको निकाल दिया गया?
अभी कह नहीं सकते।
हमें जो जानकारी मिली है सीनियर अफसरों के मुताबिक कि लाल किले से सभी प्रदर्शनकारियों को निकाल लिया गया है। भारी पुलिस बल की तैनाती फिलहाल यहां अंदर की जा रही है। अंदर काफ़ी तोड़फोड़ भी हुई है, उसको देखने के लिए जो इलाके के सीनियर अफसर है वो अंदर फिलहाल गए हैं। लेकिन जो बड़ी खबर है वो यही है कि लाल किले के अंदर से सभी प्रदर्शनकारियों को बाहर निकाल लिया गया है।
आधी रात से ज़्यादा का समय हो चुका है और किसानों का जो जत्था था, क्योंकि बहुत सारे ट्रैक्टर इस जीटी करनाल रोड से होते हुए सिंघू बॉर्डर पहुंच चुके हैं। यहां से कुछ दूरी पर ही सिंघू बॉर्डर है और यहीं से ट्रैक्टरों का जत्था आगे बढ़ा था जो लाल किले तक भी पहुंचा था। आधी रात को अब सड़कों पर सन्नाटा है। हालांकि ट्रैक्टर की संख्या इतनी ज़्यादा थी कि रह रह के अभी भी जो ट्रैक्टर, उनकी आवाज़ हम सुन पाते हैं, उनका जो म्यूज़िक सिस्टम उससे पहचान में आती है, आगे झंडे हैं वो लगातार इस रास्ते से गुजरते हुए सिंघू बॉर्डर की ओर जा रहे हैं। हालांकि सड़क का जो दूसरा हिस्सा है वहां से हमें ट्रैक्टरों की कोई मूवमेंट नहीं दिखाई पड़ती जो दिल्ली की ओर या बाहरी दिल्ली की सीमाओं की ओर जा रहे हों। जाहिर है जो सुरक्षा व्यवस्था है वो पहले से इतनी मजबूत कर दी गई है। हालांकि बड़ी संख्या में ऐसे ट्रैक्टर थे जिन्होंने आउटर रिंग रोड पर कदम भी नहीं रखे, उनके पहिए इसी रोड से यानी मुकरबा जो चौक है वहीं से ही यूटर्न लेना शुरू कर दिया था। पुलिस की जो व्यवस्था थी वो आगे लगातार बनी हुई है और जैसे ही किसान संगठनों की ओर से ये आह्वान किया गया कि तमाम किसान फिर से लौटे अपने उन जगहों पर जहां से आंदोलन शुरू हुआ था, ज़्यादातर बीच रास्ते से ही लौटने लगे थे क्योंकि स्थिति ये इस इलाके में कम से कम नियंत्रण में थी। ज़्यादातर जो पुलिस के लोग थे या इनकी जो वॉलंटियर्स हैं किसान आंदोलन के, उनसे जुड़े हुए लोग थे, वो हालात पर नियंत्रण बनाए हुए थे कि कम से कम इस इलाके में कोई गड़बड़ी ना हो। आधी रात के समय सन्नाटा है, ज़्यादातर किसान अपने आंदोलन के स्थल पर पहुँच चुके हैं और जाहिर है अगले दिन पर नज़र होगी कि अब सुरक्षा व्यवस्था कैसी होगी, किसान संगठन आगे क्या करेंगे, उनकी आगे की कार्यवाही क्या होगी। लेकिन गणतंत्र दिवस पर जो कुछ भी हुआ उन तस्वीरों के बाद इस आंदोलन को लेकर कई सारे सवाल खड़ा हो गए हैं। सिंघू बॉर्डर के पास आधी रात को पवन के साथ में आशुतोष मिश्रा, आज तक।
A lot of questions over who these protesters are. Well, answers to that are slowly trickling in really hours after that violent protest and days after he was summoned by the NIA over allegedly funneling Khalistani money in the Seek for Justice case. Punjabi actor Deep Sidhu, you see him on your screens there, he finds himself again in the eye of a storm after his video atop the Red Fort went viral online. He can be seen surrounded by loads of protesters who were involved in hoisting the Sikh flag at the Red Fort. Former activist Yogendra Yadav, following last afternoon's violence, had claimed that Deep Sidhu was involved in instigating the protesters and the farmer unions were opposed to him being a part of this agitation from the start. After facing a lot of flak, with the unions also taking him on, Deep Sidhu issued a statement saying that he didn't incite violence at Red Fort and claimed that when he reached, thousands were already present there.
दीप सिद्धू ने जो किया है हम उसकी कड़े शब्दों में निंदा करते हैं और हमें लगता है वो सरकार का दलाल है, बहुत दिन पहले से गड़बड़ कर रहा है। 12 लाल किले पे जाने का कोई प्रोग्राम नहीं था, वो बागी होके गया है और लोगों को भी उसके जो बहकावे में इस बात पे आगे कि हम रिंग रोड पे जाएंगे, लोगों को भी ये मालूम नहीं था कि लाल किले पे जाएगा।
लाल किले के भीतर जाके झंडा फहराना तिरंगे के अलावा दूसरा, उसके अंदर दीप सिद्धू ने बिल्कुल खुल के भूमिका अदा की। ये वो दीप सिद्धू हैं जो पिछले 4 महीने से किसान संगठनों के साथ लिपटने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं। किसान संगठनों ने कहा है कि इस व्यक्ति को बिल्कुल दूर रखा जाएगा क्योंकि इनके अलगाववादी रुझान है। ये वो दीप सिद्धू हैं जो आज माइक लेके लाल किले के अंदर बोल रहे हैं, माइक लेके बोल रहे हैं लाल किले में। किसने माइक ला के दिया इनको, कैसे बोल रहे हैं, अभी तक अरेस्ट क्यों नहीं हुए?
ये घटना किसी ने सोच के या किसी ने प्लान करके किसी ने नहीं की है। ये एक जो बहाव है, एक फ्लो है, उस फ्लो में लोक संघर्ष में उन्होंने अपना प्रोटेस्ट सिंबॉलिकली जाहिर किया, जहां पहले उन्होंने निशान साहब और फिर किसान मजदूर एकता का झंडा लगाया और उसके पीछे तिरंगा लगा हुआ है। आज भी अगर किसानों ने या जो लोग गए थे दिल्ली, वो किसी को मारने थोड़ी गए थे, या किसी को हमने मारा हो, या कोई पब्लिक प्रॉपर्टी को हमने नुकसान पहुंचाया हो, या किसी दिल्ली वासी को हमने नुकसान पहुंचाया हो, या हमारे हाथ में कोई हथियार हो।
What we witnessed yesterday in the national capital was shocking. There was vandalism, violence, clashes, chaos, all of that unfolding in a matter of hours. And India Today tracked the protesters from the Ghazipur border right up to the Red Fort. Here's a report on exactly how this particular violence broke out. A ground report by Ankit Tyagi.
I just want to show you once again, because the farmers have started ahead of their time. Now they are trying to break the barricades at the Ghazipur border. You can see these farmers, in fact, on one hand, on one tractor has been stopped by the police personnel. Okay, this is a full confrontation brewing here at the Ghazipur border, where the farmers are being stopped. The policeman standing right in front of this tractor and asking them to stop. And on the other side, you can see the barricades being broken by the farmers here. This is a very tense situation, ladies and gentlemen, where the barricades are being completely pushed and being broken by the farmers, saying that they have started their tractor rally and they will be going on to their route. I just want to show you that this is the route which goes towards ITO and Rajghat. The farmers are, in fact, now the tractors in front are breaking these concrete slabs which were kept by the Delhi police. I will show you that the tractors are continuously ramming them so that they can make their way through. What you can see are these farmers and the tractors on the other side ramming one by one all those concrete barricades which were put by the police. Okay, there is a lot of hooligan elements here, not letting us shoot, but I want to show you the tear gas shells are being lobbed here because they were trying to go towards India Gate. The police trying to stop them. Men with, clubs, extremely aggressive, extremely, extremely aggressive. This is the 6th tear gas shell which has been lobbed. It now looks like a confrontation which might just go out of hands. The police is now moving forward. It looks like we are going to see lathi charge just any moment. On the other side, all these protesters with clubs in their hands are also moving towards the police. It's an eyeball-to-eyeball confrontation right now. There is one gentleman who is trying to defuse the situation. And there it goes. Tear gas shells once again being lobbed by the police right deep into the farmers, those who are standing at the ITO intersection. One after another, 1, 2, 3, I can count. 3 more go there and you'll see them dropping. There it goes. Hits one protester on his stun grenades also being used. The police using all that they have at their disposal. One after another, ITO to try. Comes in. Another tractor comes in. They're using tractors as tanks right now. Ramming everything on their way. All right. It's a steel road. It was one of the dividers which has been broken by the farmers. It's a steel road that was hurled at me. Dinesh has been hit by a stone in his stomach. Now imagine, is this the kind of protest that was promised by the farmers? 60 days of being patient, 60 days of peace have been broken by these elements who have come in the last 3-4 days. They actually feel they are winning Delhi. You will hear, Delhi ko fateh karne aaye hain. What are they going to liberate Delhi from? It's their own country on the Republic Day. This is what they are showing us. I have a very disturbing news. The tractor which was ramming, this tractor has in fact completely gone turtle. It's turned turtle. And I think one protester, I can't confirm, but the allegation is that protester died after somebody opened fire. We can't confirm that. That's the allegation, but I can show you that one of the protesters has in fact passed away. That group of people that you see are claiming that a person has died and it was the same person that we saw near the tractor which has toppled. But at this moment, what we can tell you is at least the situation has been slightly under control.
A strong message being sent by the farmers, but the lawlessness, the anarchy and the violence that we saw on the streets of Delhi, especially from where we were reporting earlier at ITO, will definitely raise a question: at what cost has this symbolic gesture of putting their flag on top of Republic Day has come for the farmers' movement, which was peaceful for the last couple of months? With camera person Dinesh Lal, Ankit Tyagi, at the Red Fort.
And as expected, all of this violence has also turned political, with a slew of opposition leaders training their guns at the Modi government over the chaos that broke out in Delhi on Republic Day. The Aam Aadmi Party has targeted the centre, holding it completely responsible for the escalation of the situation. DMK chief M.K. Stalin also pinned the blame on the centre for the violence, claiming it will help the government to divert attention. Hitting out at the government, NCP chief Sharad Pawar said that the Modi government should now seriously consider the farmers' legitimate demands. Hitting back, the BJP slammed the protesters for storming into Delhi and indulging in violence. Karnataka Agriculture Minister B.C. Patil went a step further, referred to these protesters as terrorists. Now, a protesting farmer had also died near Delhi's ITO after the tractor that he was driving turned turtle. Protesters claimed that this tractor had overturned after the Delhi police fired at it. Cops, meanwhile, have denied that charge, ruling out any police excesses or police firing.
Unprecedented chaos in the national capital. Repeated bids to bust barricades using tractors at high speed. In the melee that ensued near Delhi's ITO, one of the protesting farmers lost his life, apparently after his tractor overturned while he tried to ram a police barricade at full speed. The deceased was identified as 30-year-old Navneet Singh from Bajpur area of Uttarakhand. Protesters wrapped Navneet's body in national flag and staged a dharna at arterial ITO intersection, claiming that he was killed in police firing.
पुलिस कह रही है कि पत्थरबाजी हुई थी पुलिस तो झूठी है एक नंबर की जो पुलिस एक्सपायर आंसू गोले मार रही है उससे क्या किसी की डेथ नहीं हो सकती
तो उन्होंने आंसू के गोले क्यों मारे क्या प्रोवोकेशन था
वो दिल्ली में एंट्री करने नहीं देना चाहते जबकि दिल्ली किसी की जागीर नहीं है
मैं सुबह सिंघू बॉर्डर पे था बड़ा शांति से पूरी हर चीज शांति से चल रही थी
हम तो अपना खाना तक लेके नहीं आए हम क्या पत्थर लेके आएंगे हम तो ट्रैक्टर ड्राइव करेंगे पत्थर मारेंगे
The Delhi police released the CCTV images of the incident and clarified that no bullet was fired and called the death an accident due to high-speed driving. The cops were later seen extricating the body from the wreckage of the tractor.
उनकी तरफ से ये पूरा आश्वासन था कि ये चीजें सब सही चलेंगी। जो उग्र किसान थे, उन्होंने क्या किया? उन्होंने ट्रैक्टर से लोगों को, पुलिस वालों को, सुरक्षा बलों को कुचलने की कई जगह कोशिश की गई। बैरिकेड्स तोड़ दिए गए, जो हमारे बसेज थी, पुलिस की बसेज थी, उनको तोड़ दिया गया और इस तरीके से व्यापक पैमाने पर तोड़फोड़ की और नुकसान किया।
Over 60 policemen who suffered serious injuries in the mob attacks have been hospitalized. Bureau Report, India Today.
Let's move on to some other stories that we're tracking this morning. A lot of updates coming in from Polbon, Tamil Nadu, where the Chief Minister, Edappadi Palaniswamy, will be unveiling the memorial of late AIADMK Supremo and Chief Minister Jayalalitha. The move, seen as a bid to claim the legacy of Jayalalitha by the OPS-APS government, comes on a day where Jayalalitha's former aide V.K. Sashikala will be released from prison. The memorial, resembling a phoenix with two granite lion statues at the entrance, will be unveiled near the memorial of Jayalalitha's political mentor, AIADMK founder, Dr. MGR. The memorial houses a state-of-the-art museum as well as a knowledge park, while the museum would have a chronicle of the events in Jayalalitha's life through audio-visual presentations. The knowledge park will have digital shows on her many achievements and her speeches. A life-size statue of Jayalalitha was also installed at this memorial site. Chief Minister Palaniswamy had laid the foundation stone for the memorial back in 2018. It's been constructed at a cost of 79 crores and 75 lakhs.
With just months to go for elections, the state assembly elections, several developments are occurring in the state of Tamil Nadu, and behind us is one such important thing. This is a memorial that is being built for former Chief Minister Jayalalitha. This memorial is in Marina Beach, and this is being constructed with a budget of almost 80 crore rupees. Now, initially, this memorial was to be opened on 24th of February, as per sources. That was the birthday of Jayalalitha. However, what's happening currently is that certain changes have occurred, which also could be a reason or an outcome of when Sashikala is going to be released as well. As you might know, Sashikala was the close confidant of former Chief Minister Jayalalitha, who is buried at this location. And apparently this entire structure, which is also echoing as we speak, is constructed in a format of a phoenix, because she had some affection towards the phoenix, a bird that rose from the ashes, such way trying to say that Jayalalitha, no matter what kind of issues she was suffering from, always turned victorious. So in that pattern, this building has been constructed, memorial. And what's happening is that the interesting fact here is that after the information came out about Sashikala's release on 27th of January, the very same day has been allotted for opening this memorial. On 27th of January, just a couple of days, the Chief Minister is going to unveil this memorial on the same day when Sashikala is going to exit from prison. The Chief Minister and the Deputy Chief Minister are going to be there. That's a place you could see at this spot currently. And what's happening is that through sources, it seems that this is also a well-planned tactic to make sure that public's attention does not go towards Sashikala, but stay with Jayalalitha itself. In fact, this is also very clearly planned. You could see on that side, that is MGR's memorial, the founder of AIADMK, the former Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu. And currently, right next to it, you have the former Chief Minister Jayalalitha's memorial. Such way a battle for legacy is occurring in the state of Tamil Nadu. Very clearly, Kamal Haasan wants to show that he is the extension of MGR's legacy, but at the same time, AIADMK is not ready to go ahead and give it up. In such a manner, Chief Minister Edappadi K. Palaniswamy wants to show that he is the extension of Jayalalitha's legacy, and that way it has been planned to be unveiled on 27th of January. And this location, this pattern, called as visual thoughts from a phoenix bird, has been constructed, a Pegasus kind of formation, a mythical horse with wings. That's also, you could see right outside in this memorial also, that is also being placed over here. And that manner, this memorial has been constructed. Just final touches are occurring as we speak in this area. And this is going to play apparently a very important role in Tamil Nadu elections of 2021. With camera person Divyan, Pramod Madhav, for India Today.
Interestingly, V.K. Sashikala's four-year jail term is also set to end today. However, she will not be able to just walk out because she's been hospitalized after testing positive for coronavirus on January 20th. She's currently recovering in Bengaluru's Victoria Hospital and will be able to walk out only once her health improves, once she tests negative for COVID. Sashikala's release papers will be ready by 10 a.m. Prison authorities will send the documents for her signature. Sashikala, remember, was sentenced to jail term by the Supreme Court in 2017 in a disproportionate assets case, along with her sister-in-law, J. Ilavarasi, and former Tamil Nadu Chief Minister Jayalalitha's foster son, V.N. Sudhakar.
Hello, everyone. This is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.